Hey everybody, and welcome to a new game. I had quite a few requests for games that people wanted me to play. For example, somebody asked me to do a random Pangea playthrough, or show a specific strategy, play a specific map. And yeah, unfortunately, I did not have that much time recently. I mean, I have that list that I keep updating, that I want to go through. But yeah, I'm kind of limited to only a few games now, at least until Christmas, when I'll have more time again. So I figured I'd play the new Nobles Cup edition. And yeah, when I get time, or when I'll have more time, I'll start doing map votes again, where you can directly show me what kind of game you want me to play. Yeah, I'll put together 4 or 5 starting locations, and then you can vote. I definitely want to do that, because I have no idea. I mean, should I play more isolation games? Should I play more Pangea or whatever? And I definitely want to find that out. But okay, for now let's play Nobles Club 191 with Frederick of Germany. DRT difficulty, no huts, no events, and I think it's a small map for starters, and I think it's Highlands again, which I have played recently, but I don't know, it shouldn't matter too much, I feel. And I mean, for all I know, this might be some kind of Pangea game, so we'll find that out. Okay, we are playing with Frederick. He is philosophical and organized. Philosophical is probably the single best trait in the game, in my opinion, because especially on DRT, your strategy usually involves, or it builds around bulbing and getting great people quicker, and because of that getting more great people for bulbing and stuff like that. That's always useful, yeah. It's always a cornerstone of any kind of strategy that you might choose, whether you are going for liberalism, astronomy, construction attack, horse archer rush, and yeah, you're always going to want great people. And the trait is very versatile and is always useful, yeah. Compare that to financial, which, you know, on a map like here, Highlands with not many rivers, probably. I'd rather be philosophical. Yeah, I think it's always useful. And you get cheaper universities, which can also be nice. They are quite expensive. Of course, I usually don't go for Oxford, but if I wanted to go that way, play the long game, I would definitely like that, that bonus. So I think that's very nice. Organized is a second very strong economic trait, even though it's a bit less visible maybe, since you are saving upkeep, civic upkeep throughout the game. But maybe you don't notice that, you know, you're still losing money and you think, oh, I'm losing money, and you don't realize that you would lose way more money if you didn't have organized. So even I tend to underrate the trade, but I think throughout the game it can be useful. Also, I like that you get cheap lighthouses, cheap courthouses, even though courthouses, again, not my favorite building. But it opens up a possibility that you might want to go into. So it's not bad. It's also very versatile, and I think it can support many playstyles, and yeah, I am very fond of my traits here. I think that's very, very strong. Okay, Germany, we are starting with hunting and mining. I think it's a very good combination. You can get to animal husbandry very early, or pretty much directly. So if you start with I don't know, plains cow or whatever, you can improve that. You don't depend on having agriculture stuff like many other leaders who don't start with hunting or agriculture. Also, you get quick archery in case you need it, which I tend to do in my games. So I do like having archery, hunting. Mining, of course, very useful, quick bones working. So I think it's a very good combination. Above average, maybe not the best, but you can certainly work with that. The unique building is a factory which gets built quicker if you have coal. And of course by that point in the game you usually will have coal. And I am organized, right? So I'm getting my factories up, or I can get them up very, very quickly. And I think that's good, because I get to that point in the game quite often, and it's always hard to build factories, you know, they're very expensive and you have to start a golden age or whip them, but with Germany you can get them in like 5 turns. In like 5 turns, and you don't need much production for that. And I think it's very nice, actually. Definitely enjoy that. And okay, so what remains is the unique unit. It's a tank which gets +50% against other tanks or against armored units, which basically means tanks and, well, modern armor. But the thing is, if you attack with tanks, you will run into fortified infantry, marines. Anyway, it's tanks are not usually the biggest problem. AI doesn't build enough of them, so I don't think that's very useful, but I do like the traits, I do like the starting text, and yeah, the unique building late game can also be useful. Okay, but enough talk, let's get into the game. I have looked at the starting screenshot a little bit, and well, basically I don't see any fish, right, and I think I want to move. I would move towards the river here, but my scout is kind of out of position, so I have no idea what's over here. So that's a question mark. Or I would go on the plains hill, get the extra production, and also the reason for that is that I am on the coast, right? But being on the coast is not always that useful. It depends, it can be good if you want to go for Great Lighthouse or whatever, but generally speaking I would rather move inland and block more land with that by doing that. So I think well, that's not that great, but I still think that the plains hill, you can justify going on that and moving away from here. I don't think I need the coast. I'd rather have extra production. And maybe also if there's fish here, I can get that later. So okay. Mansa Musa is in the game, judging by the soldier count. So we definitely want to find him early if we can. Yeah, I mean I'm giving up a plains cow, but I am gaining a quicker start. Yes, I am moving 2 turns, and that's not ideal. But I'm also getting the worker, I'm still getting the worker 1 turn earlier, okay? And it will help me to get a quicker start, and I don't think I lose much. Okay, we are going here. Of course you could argue or think about that even longer, I don't want to overanalyze that. I thought about it quite a bit, and I think it's a good idea. Yeah, I will go agriculture, worker first. And okay, we have marble, but apart from that, the area here is not that great. And I might go to the east and figure out what's over here on the river. Even though I don't think it's a long river, it's like 1 tile, 2 tiles. Yeah, you could have moved here, but I didn't want to give up a pig, and without being able to know what's over here. There might be like desert and... yeah, I didn't want to risk that. Okay. We'll try to meet somebody and get a boost for my research if I meet somebody before putting beakers into that. I can delay that until turn 5. And yeah, we are going worker first. We will improve the corn, of course, after that. Probably animal husbandry. I don't think I need to go for bronze working here. And okay, yeah, we met. Yeah, so we met our first neighbor. It's not the kind of guy that you want to have in your neighborhood, that's for sure. Quite aggressive. Not sure how close he is, but he didn't get his second city yet. So for all I know, he might pop like right here, and ooh, it's not good. I hope there's somebody else to attack for him. There should be, but he's fairly close, and we might have to deal with that rather early. Okay, I want to figure out how far away he is, so I will. Oh man. Oh my god, dude. Don't do that. No. Oof. Oh man. That's not. Yeah. And he gets gold and flood plains and sheep. Oh man, what do I have? I have enough food, but yeah. That's quite aggressive of you. Okay, so that's his capital, and he moved towards me. Okay. It's not good. Not good. Okay, I want to be a bit careful about barbarians. Now the good news is he's kind of fog busting for me. So I might not have to go for archery. Of course, I might have to go to archery anyway to defend against him, but yeah. And okay, I don't think he met anybody yet, but okay, so we have ivory and gold, even though I'm not sure how I'm going to get the gold. We have a bit of food here. But if I want that fish, I have to go here pretty much. And that does not get the gold. I would like, if the fish was like here, I could go here and secure the gold, but I'm not that lucky apparently. I think I want to check out the area over here. I definitely have to block a bit of land because my cultural borders kind of block him from going to the west, right? So I'm more interested in getting a bit of land down here before he gets it. And later I can hopefully backfill. But we might have to go for an early attack here. And oh, okay, well, I have a bit of gold here. And I have even more gold. Okay, well. That's nice. I hope I can get it before he does. Yeah, that idiot man. He's pretty much on my border already. Ugh. It looks to me like I don't think he's anybody closer to him. I am the closest, and he pretty much has to go through me. I think I'm blocking him off, right? He has nowhere to go since he went towards me. And yeah. It's not very encouraging. Okay, we got agriculture. I think. Well, I have gold available to myself, so I think I'll go for animal husbandry because I will definitely go here, Plains Cow, get the gold. I think right here on the Plains Hill. Oh no, wait a second. If I do that, I won't have the Plains Cow until turn 50. That's a long time. I think I will go here instead. Get to Plains Cow immediately. And I will grab the ivory. And probably attack him pretty early with a construction attack. Yeah. So yeah, I think I will go animal husbandry. And after that, maybe early writing again. But I think I will have enough commerce, that's very good. Okay, I will fog bust a bit, like right here. I think that's a good position. It's a good position, I think. I'm fog busting pretty much the whole area. And yeah, okay. I get other warrior, I will need a guy. And I think I will go for a settler like size 2. Because I have to get that before he does. That's very important. And he might have met a guy, I don't know. It's too early to tell, but if I am alone with him, I mean, there might be some other continent that you can reach by workboat, but if I'm alone with him on the landmass, I think we will have to fight pretty much. I don't really see another solution to that. I'm not quite ready for animal husbandry. It's a bit unfortunate. I could build a farm here for 2 turns, but what's the point? Could mine that. Yeah, it's not. Yeah, I could mine that and then replace it with a. Yeah, that's a bit stupid. The building a farm here is completely pointless, so I will move on the tile and then figure out what I want to do. And I won't even finish a warrior, I will just go straight for a settler. I could build a mine and then replace it with a pasture. That might mean I will get the settler 1 turn earlier, because I can work a good tile a bit for 2 turns. No, I mine that, and when I build a pasture, it's a bit of a waste of worker turns, but not sure I have anything better to do. On the other hand, I could build a mine. Nah, I think I will just wait for 2 turns. When I can build a mine, and I will need production, since I am delaying bronze working a bit. And if I don't have horses, I will also have to go for archery. Or maybe I don't. I don't know. I don't know how much land we have to the west. Highlands barbarians are usually quite bad. So I don't know, but I think I will wait here. I mean, just build a mine for 2 turns and I will kind of think about that. Nah, I don't think it makes sense to finish a mine. Maybe, no, I don't think it does. I don't think it makes sense. Okay, animal husbandry and... Okay, we don't have anything. So we have to decide about that. I have double gold. So going archery is not a big problem. Since commerce won't be an issue in a moment here. So I think I will go archery because I need something to build. And I could go for writing, but I need units. I need units, I need to scout, and I don't trust warriors to do the defense. I'm sure there will be a few barbarians coming in. I mean, looks like there's more land to the south here and the west, and I don't want to risk it. And I will need archery anyway against Napoleon. He might attack me very early if he finds metal. So I don't think I lose much by going archery. And after archery, I will probably go for, I don't know, writing maybe. So I think I will go right here, and I also have to go get the ivory before he gets it. So I might go archery, maybe even bronze working to get a few chops. And I'm delaying the wheel, but I don't think I need the wheel for now. Because, well... I won't be putting down many cottages, and I won't be whipping a lot. There is not enough food here to whip too much. So pottery is not that attractive. And I can delay the wheel because I have enough commerce, and I don't have a worker turns to build many roads anyway. Oh god damn it, yeah, that's what I mean. There's another archer here, 2 archers. I would feel better if I have archery myself. So, yeah. Yeah, I think bronze working, chop out a few units. I need another settler to go for the fish here before he gets it. Or more specifically, I need the ivory, I really do. And chopping once or twice would definitely help with that. I can't build a library yet, even if I go writing now. I have to build archers and worker and going the wheel. I don't have a worker turns to build roads right now. I have to build mines, I have to chop, I have to build a pasture, and building roads right now is not the biggest priority. But okay, I will mine that, and I don't think he has metal yet. He did not go for bronze working yet. Okay. Good to know. I hope he didn't build Stonehenge. No, I don't need the culture from him. Don't need that crap. I really don't. Okay, and we will finish with the warrior and then go straight for an archer. And I mean, I kind of want to go for a settler out of a gate, but the cutoff date for barbarians is coming closer, and okay, well, I don't think there can be a barbarian. Here. So next turn I can move, and I definitely need the archer. I mean, if that guy comes over, I have no defense. That's not good. Obviously, that's not very good. And yeah, bronze working, I think that's a good idea. I think it's a good idea. I mean, what else would I go for, you know? Might as well go for bronze working and then maybe mysticism for the monument, and then we'll go for writing and stuff like that. But we can't really do it right now. Okay. Okay, we have a guy here. Yeah, this warrior I kind of want to fortify here. He might kill a few guys. And okay. And over here in the east I will have an archer. I hope. If it gets really bad, I can sacrifice a scout. Well, saying that, maybe the warrior wouldn't be too bad. I mean, a bit of extra defense, you know. Nah, I want to go here. I want to fortify him. I have to defend my new settlement for now. I don't know. Anyway, I hope Napoleon might take him out. I really hope that. Okay, we go right here. I think that guy went away. I hope there's no barbarian here, but there shouldn't be. Okay. Okay, we will grow and maybe get an archer out, because I could really use an archer. Maybe even two. Okay, there's no good way to go here, so we will go for the plains cow. Yeah, I think I should get the archer here in time, so this warrior can go to the east. I will get the archer out here and then go straight for settler. Maybe, yeah, would be good to have another mine, but I don't. I have more important things to do. So should be fine. Oh man, I think that's another archer. Yeah. I have to get there with an archer. Phew. Great War, please don't. Ah, okay. Yeah, it would have been bad if he got that. Okay, I keep watching that guy. If it gets really bad, I can sacrifice a scout. Like, go here and he will take him out. And I gain a turn doing that. Okay, Archer, when we go straight for Settler, we don't have time to lose. He might go here at any moment. Okay, he attacked, that's nice, and now I can fortify here. And I... oh my god. Yeah, I think he's going for it. So he goes boom, boom, boom. I would be just in time. But... I wonder if I should... if I should gain a bit more time. Because if he comes in here, I can't improve the gold mine, right? I will have to defend my capital. Oh, not my capital, but my... my city. So I think I would rather bait him into moving here, and then I have time to move my archer on the hill, maybe, you know. I think that's a good idea, kind of. Okay, and he has a work put out, and yeah, he did not meet anybody yet, so that's a bit disappointing. And nobody found me yet. Nobody else found me yet. Oh, and I might need have to get another archer here, if anybody comes. It should work out, though. Yeah, okay. That's not a big shock. But that gives me a bit of time. Get another archer. Yeah, I'm sure that guy will come here like any moment now. Oh no, 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 don't do that. Ah, you bastard. I might have to declare on him. I have to declare on him if he tries to get the ivory, because that's like, that's pretty much game over. Well, maybe not, but I don't have horses, you know. Oh man, now that guy's coming here. Yeah, I mean, if I don't get the ivory, it's like... I hope he doesn't get any stupid idea, I really hope. I really hope he doesn't. And there's nothing I can do. I could put an archer here and declare on him, and then he won't be able to... I don't know, but that's a long shot. I'm not even sure if that's going to work. Well, that archer went away, so that's good. Crap. Oh man. That's bad. That's really bad. I'm not even sure. I mean, let's get to the settler one turn earlier, but oh, that might be really bad. Please don't tell me. I'm not sure, he might be here, and he might like go here. Oh man. I don't know. Yeah, get out that guy. Not sure if it's going to help me, but I have no choice, I mean. Okay, I have two archers now. I might put a few hammers into a worker. Since I will need one. Okay, I'm not sure what happened, but he did not come here. Apparently. So that's good. I'm not sure why. But okay, no, I will another archer maybe. I have to grow here. And okay, you know why I have to grow here? I have to get to size 4, and there's a reason for that. Because I can't work both gold mines and the cow if I don't have size 4. Because think about it, if I do it like that, I'm starving. And if I do it like that, I can't work the cow. So I have to reach size 4. So I can work the corn, the cow, and both goals, and which I really want to do. I want to work both goals for obvious reasons. I'm kind of nervous because I have to move this archer to the west. Or maybe I don't. Because I have to protect my stuff here. So, I mean, there might be a barbarian like coming in any moment. But yeah, I have to move back and get another archer out. And at size 4 I will get a worker, probably. Berlin, if it gets really bad, I can still get an archer, I hope. Okay. I'm still in the game. Oh no. Okay, this archer might be going for him, so that's nice. Which means I can go into position here. And I might not have to get another archer, I can go straight for a worker in Berlin. Yeah. Okay, that's good. It was a tense situation here there for a second, but I think we got it. Oh, and I won the fight. But now it's getting even... Oh man. I think I will stay here, because I am fortified. I am hurt a bit, but I have Woodsman 1, okay? I should have winning odds against that guy. And... yeah, he might die. Archer rush from Napoleon. Oh, he needs metal to attack me. Okay, and I have to get the ivory now, because it's kind of key, and I will improve the gold before doing anything else. Another archer, and yeah, we go for a worker. I mean, I will have two archers. I have one archer here. Though I have to admit, I would feel a bit better if I had another archer. Nah, it should be fine, right? Get the worker out. Please don't die. Yeah. Okay, that's nice. Ooh, I hope there's no barbarian here. Well, he settled. So he did not go on the ivory, at least. Okay, this archer is coming here. I could engage him on the hill. I think I will do that, because I don't want him to come in. He might smash my pasture. That's the kind of stuff they do, and I will have another archer defending my capital if it gets really bad, you know. Ugh. I don't want to go into slavery. I think I have to go for mysticism for that fish. Yeah, I will build a worker here at size 4. Oh man. Okay. Well, I can. Yeah. mean, there shouldn't be a barbarian here, you know? There shouldn't be one, but don't want to risk it. I don't think I am in a hurry. So I will make sure I don't get killed. Yeah, okay, so we are getting that worker and building a barracks because I don't need another archer right now. And I will start on a worker on at size 4. I could also think about gifting him a city. Because I want, okay, so let's talk about the plan here, right? I don't think he met anybody. Nobody found me. It's pretty likely that we are alone. And if I am alone with one neighbor, I usually don't attack him. Because I like to have a trading partner. And it's usually more beneficial to keep him alive, to keep your neighbor alive, because even if you took him out, you can't really afford to settle the whole continent on your own, because you don't have currency, you don't have any, you are lacking economic technology usually. So the thing would be to play peaceful, to get astronomy and take them out later once you have the tech to do it, you know, but once you have the ability to support a big empire. But in this case we have Napoleon, I can't get him too friendly, he won't get a religion, he might attack me any moment, he might go for my capital. My land is not that great, it's nice for now, but it's not enough to... I mean, I would have to scout more, but I don't think it's enough to really play peaceful, you know. So I think I will go for a construction attack. And the key here is to balance the attack with economic development. So I can reach astronomy while I go for him pretty much. And that's going to be a bit ambitious, but I think we will have to try and do that, because playing peacefully, I don't think that's going to work with him. I can't get him too friendly, his favorite civic is representation, which I am not going to get for a long time. Yeah, I can gift him a city, but it's not going to solve the problem. And he is not a good trading partner. So I think I will go for him, because I don't have a choice, and yeah, so we are planning for that. I will take horseback riding, I will bulb mathematics, I am philosophical, I can get a scientist quite early, and we will go for him. And I will get the ivory, and that's it. I won't expand any further than that, because it would only delay my attack, I think. So yeah, we will try to do that. Okay, I won the fight, barely, but I won the fight. And okay, there's one more guy coming, this archer has to heal. And okay, let's get the worker out. I will have 3 workers, that's pretty good. Well, you know, I might still gift him a city. Because if I do that, he will like me a bit. And I don't want him to attack me before I'm ready. I would have to defend with archers. Oh yeah. I don't have copper. Don't have copper, so it would be really annoying. He might smash my gold. And also, if I want to go to slavery, now would be a good time. But I don't think I do. I don't think I will whip anything in this game, to be honest. Not for a long time. Only later. So instead of going slavery and wasting a turn, I will just not do that. I can chop an army, and I can produce with the hills and stuff. So we will try to do it like that. Okay, I have to defend my... Oh man, he might go on the hill and be really annoying to me, but I can't really do much about that for now, unfortunately. I might almost need another archer, but I can get him out here. Yeah, he might be annoying. He might really do that. He might go on the freaking hill and... I mean, he won't take my capital, I can tell you that right now, but... it's still annoying. Okay, get that in 2 turns. Just in time to start on the monument, actually. Then I go for the wheel, probably. Or go for writing, actually, and chop a bunch of libraries, because I need something to build. I have nothing to build here. Yeah. Okay, that's good. He attacked and died. This warrior should survive that fight. And I think this worker will chop a monument out. Chop out a monument, because I really want that. It's a good thing to get. And... yeah. Okay, we will do that. Worker, yeah, I might build a settler and I might build a settler and gift it to him, because I don't like the idea of him attacking me before I'm ready. And that might make him happy for a bit, you know. So we might do that. And yeah, I think go for writing. What happened here? Okay, I won the fight. That's good. That guy is healing. I could offer him to try to do it like that. Just to make sure, because if he wins that fight, I lose my capital. I'm a bit paranoid, but just because I'm paranoid doesn't mean he won't win the fight, you know? So, think about that. Yeah, so I'm happy I got that. And actually, I wanted to chop the monument, I'm not even sure. I think I will do it. I mean, I can just produce it like that, but yeah, whatever. Okay, so I have this worker. I could go here, build a mine. Should maybe do that. Yeah, I mean, he won't win the fight. Come on. Yeah, another worker, and yeah, I might build that settler. I really might. Okay. That's good. And with the archer, I don't know. I maybe get a barracks first. I want to grow a bit here. Which means I have no good tile to work, really. It's annoying, but not much you can do. Yeah, I can... I think it's worth it to chop that. And I will gift him a settler, because I... oh, he got iron already. He could really come in early. So, yeah, I think I want to gift him a guy. To... lower the chance of him coming in like turn 65, you know, and I don't like that idea. I don't like that idea one bit. I will go scout a bit. Go for writing. Ooh. Well, that guy's coming in. I might take him out in the open if he... okay, I had the border pop. Oh, I have forces, okay. Oh, good to know. Good to know. I can't build roads, unfortunately. So I think I will chop one tile. Because I want to chop the library, I think. Don't think it's a bad idea. Okay, I have a few archers. If he attacks me, I can get out a few more really quickly. But we will get that settler and we'll chop him actually. We don't have a connection yet, so I can't even gift him anything. But after writing, we will go for the wheel, build a road to him, and then we will gift that. Okay, I think that's a good plan. Okay. Yeah, we will go here, and if he goes in the open, I take him out, pretty much. Oh, and he... Okay, so he went in the north, okay. Yeah, I might gift him something like to the west, you know, out of my way, just to make him happy. It won't help him too much, and I think that's a good idea. And there's the first metal unit. Yeah, I might gift him, or I'm, well, I don't want to give him the gold. No, I think I will gift him something in the desert or out of my way. It's too bad we can't trade yet, but that's okay. Okay, so we got the monument, and then we will start on our barracks. Pretty much. Okay. Okay, no, he attacked. I think I will promote to... so I can heal a bit quicker. And this archer will try to find a position where I can gift. And make no mistake, he could come in pretty early. It's kind of dangerous, actually. Okay, so I could build a mine here, or I could... Well, the camp would give one extra commerce. So maybe that's better, or... Yeah, I think that's better. I can build a mine later if I want to. Kind of waste a turn, but oh well. Yeah, I think once I have writing, I can talk to him and gift him something. I think that's how it works, not sure, but could be. Oh, can we get writing in 2 turns? I'm pretty sure we can. Yeah, we can, so let's do that. He does not have too many units yet. Okay, well, now I want to... I also have to build roads in a bit. So that means that we want to... We want to do what? I almost think that I want to go here. I can chop, build a road. That would... be a good idea. It kind of wastes 2 turns, which I don't like. I could also go here, it's a bit... Yeah, because I think I want to build a road towards him. So I will waste a bit of time, but... Yeah, after writing we'll definitely go for... Well, I also have to get fishing, but... Yeah, like right here. Gift him something crappy. That guy thinks he... He can be smart, but he can't be smart. Okay, well, I think I will mine that for lack of better things to do. Is that the best thing I can do? Yeah, maybe. And yeah, definitely get the archer out. I won't get a warning if he attacks because there's nobody else he knows. I won't get a red fist warning. It's really a bit dangerous. He has the guys to attack me, kind of. Now that's why we are doing the gifting thing. Now we go for the wheel or for fishing. Okay. No, I can. We go fishing first. Because I can. Because I can gift him, like, right. I can gift him a guy right now. I hope he's not plotting yet. He might be plotting. Okay, we will stay here. Yeah, I guess the archer. I will feel a bit better once I have the archer. Maybe even a bit more than that. Don't have to be too stingy with that. Maybe a library here, but yeah, we can definitely afford to be a bit cautious. Can't be too cautious. Yo, okay. Yeah, we go fishing and get a workboard. Maybe I will chop a workboard, or maybe not. I think I will chop a workboard. Should be worth it. Okay. Another archer coming. Well, he's still expanding, so that makes it a bit less likely that he would attack me yet, but he could do it. I mean, and I will go here and gift him some kind of crap. Yeah. Okay, we have one archer. We have two archers, and we can. I'll get another one in a moment here. Here we get a library because I kind of feel that it would be really worth it. We just hope he won't attack me. But if he does, I want to be able to survive. Okay, this warrior should win that fight. I'm still not connected, that's a bit strange, of course, but that's how it is. Okay, yeah, I will get a few more archers because let's not take any chances. He might be plotting already. Again, I won't get a warning. And yeah, it's a bit dicey. It really is. Okay, I hope I. Yeah, great. Yeah, great. Well, there goes one archer. Again, don't want to chop too much. But I just might. I think I will go here and build a farm here. sweat a bit earlier or not. Yeah, it's kind of not that worth it, not that much. I think I'll mine that and need to have a wheel actually. Wait a second here, let's build the workboat. Okay, don't have that much to chop. Yeah, it was a bit unfortunate. I can build a mine here. Nah, I can't build a mine here. 6 turns, huh? Yeah, I think I... No. Okay, I chop one more. I can pre-chop. It's not ideal though. Yeah, piece of crap, man. Okay, let's move here and oh. Well, I think I'll go like right here and he won't get the sheep for a long time. Didn't have to lose a guy, that's for sure. Don't think he is attacking me yet. So I hope I can gift it to him and before we get into trouble. Oh no. You piece of crap. Yeah, he's still expanding, I mean that's kind of good for me. I suppose. And then of course I can't get where yeah, I'll mine that, what the hell. Oh yeah, they are not going pottery. I'm paying a bit for units, I don't like to be doing that, but I don't want to die either. So it's kind of a trade-off, you know. Yeah, I wonder, he's going to go right here, but you know, I could really ruin him. Like, well, but if I go here, he will just go here, and he will get the clam anyway. I would like to really hurt him somehow, and best way I can see would be here, but if he well, I could go right here. I mean, what's the difference? It's really crappy. I think I will do that. It's really crappy. Okay, now he likes me, and if he is not plotting yet, it will reduce the chance of him plotting by a lot. I think this guy might want to scout a bit, but to be honest, I don't care. I already have made up my mind about what I want to do. Well, still, scouting wouldn't. Got the fish and mine. Get the wheel and we are chopping that kind of stuff here. Yeah, it's looking fine. And now we can go for masonry, horseback riding, arrow bulb. Ooh, fishing. Let me do some math here. I have 5, 7. Let's grow a bit. Okay, so I want to. Okay, no, I think it's a good time to take a break anyway. So I will do that. And next time we will hopefully reach construction and start our attack against the French. Yeah, I'm not expanding more than that because once I capture a few cities from him, I will be kind of at the limit. I won't have trade routes, I won't have any trading partner, and I have to reach astronomy in a reasonable time frame. And if I expand too much and then capture, I might not have enough. Yeah, I think I will just delay my astronomy date pretty much. What I have right now, that's enough to do a rush, and I'm committing to that. And that kind of means that I won't get the marble, for example. I won't get the horses, and no matter what's here, I won't be getting that. I'd rather take it from him, since I am investing into an army, and yeah, settlers are expensive, I mean. Yeah, I think that plan will give me the best chance here. I'm sure he will build many units. That's going to be an issue, but I think we can do it. Anyway, thanks for watching, and yeah, I'll continue next time.